Hello guys, welcome to our ESG project, IoT Based Digital Notice Board. I, Akash Rohila, as a group leader, and my group members Mamta Pan and Rani Kumari. So let's start. My main motive of making this project was changing analog type notice board to digital and to make a paperless community to show real time data from anywhere in the world within seconds. As you all are aware that notice boards are playing very important role in our day-to-day life by replacing conventional analog type notice board with digital notice board, we can make information much easier in a paperless community. Here, the admin can control notice board through internet, so information can be sent anywhere in the world and can be displayed within seconds. Information may be in the form of text, image, video, PDF, etc. PC or smartphone is used for sending information. Our project consists of three main blocks: power supply unit, display controller card, and P6 LED matrix. In our project, we have used 5 volt LRS150F series power supply, which is a 150 watt single output enclosed type power supply with 30 mm of low profile design, adopting the full range 85 to 264 volt AC input and 5 volt output up to 90% high efficiency. The design of metallic mesh cage enhance the heat dissipation of LRS150F that the whole series operates from minus 30 degrees Celsius through 70 degrees Celsius under air convection without a fan, delivering an extremely low no power consumption less than 0.5 watt. It allows the end system to easily meet the worldwide energy requirement. LRS150F has the complete protection function and 5G anti-vibration capability. Now, our second main block, display controller card. Here, we have used SGW60 Wi-Fi enabled controller. W6075 is a W series control card. W means Wi-Fi, which updates programmed by Wi-Fi. In addition, it has USB port, can also using the U-disk to update the program. Low cost, cost effective, simple software interface, easy to operate, better display, supports variety kind of single color and RGB display. Now, and our third main block, which is P6 LED matrix. These panels are normally used to make video walls in rental LED display market or to display animations or short video clips. They have 1024 LED, means 1024 bright RGB LEDs connectors. Bright RGB LEDs arranged in a 32x32 grid on the front of 6 mm grid. On the back, there is a PCB with a set of dual IDC connector, one input, one output. In theory, you can chain these together. And 12-to-16-bit latches that allows you to drive the display with a 1:16 scan rate. These displays are technically chainable. Connect one output to the next input. These panels require 13 digital pins, 6-bit data, 7-bit control, and a good 5-volt supply. Up to 2 ampere per panel, we suggest a 2 ampere regulated 5-volt adapter and then connecting a 2.1 mm jack. Now, let's see the working of our project. So, this is our project. You can see the messages running on the board now. I'll show you how it works. So, first of all, we need to download the application to our phone from the Play Store. Name of the application is LED Art. So, I'll show you in my phone. So, first of all, we need to go to the Play Store. After going to the Play Store, you need to search the application LED Art. So as you can see here, when I wrote LED Art, the application is shown here. You need to install this. I have already installed, so it's there. So after installing, we'll open the application. after opening the application, you will get a screen like this, a blank screen. So before making a new screen, you need to connect it to the Wi-Fi. So we'll switch on the Wi-Fi. After switching it on, you will find a network W6075, as you can see here. I have already connected with this network. You need to enter the password and you need to connect with this. So as you can see, I have already connected it. So after connecting to the Wi-Fi, we need to again go to the application. So after going to the application, you can see the blank screen here. You need to click on add button. So after you will click in the add button, you will find here that the same Wi-Fi name will be appeared here. So you need to select this and you need to click on confirm. After confirming, there will be the settings for the screen you need to do. So as you can see here, it's asking for the screen name. So we'll set any screen name you can put. After that, you need to set the height and width of the screen. So as you can see that I have used four matrix of 32x32 display. There are four matrix in this of 32x32. So there is 128, our width is 128 and our height is 32. So we'll write here, as you can see here, it is written that the width of the display is 128 and height is 32. So this is our full color display, so we'll select on full color, and then the grayscale level should be 16. After doing all these settings, setting the screen parameter, we'll click on OK. After clicking on OK, you can find the new program will be created, and as you can see here, the page is open. So after this, you can write anything on this. So I'll write hello world. So you can see here that I wrote a hello world. Now we can change many things in this. Like you can see that we have wrote here hello world. We can also change the font of the text. There are many kinds of fonts. You can set anyone. I'll take sans serif. So we have set the font. Now I'll change the size. We can also change the size of the font. So I'll set it to 20. Here this is the option for color changing. You can see single color changing. We can do it from here. You can set any of the color. You can also bold. You can also italic the text, you can underline the text, and you can set the alignment of the text. So I'll do it center. After this, you can see that there are animation effects, means you can give many type of animations to the display. Like I'll give continuously move left, means all the text will be moving continuously left. If we'll click on right, all the text will be moving continuously right. If you click on continuous move up, the text will move up. There are many effects you can apply anyone. So I'll take continuously move left. You can also change the speed of the text which is running. It's not 10. It will increase to 20. The text will be a little bit slow. You can also set the border. See, as you can see here, there are single line, the double line, triple line borders. You can select any one of them. So I'll select a border. There are many options like text rotation. You can also rotate the text. Word spacing is there. Line spacing is there. So we don't need here. So after doing all the settings, you can also apply a colorful word. As you can see here, you can also apply a colorful word. Means all the text will be in the rainbow color. So I'll select one of the colorful style. After this, if you will be completed with your program, then you need to click on send button. You can see here there is a send option. So as soon as you will click in this send option, you can see the program has been uploaded in the board. So after completion of this, you can see in the display the program will be running. So see here it's written 100% program sent successfully. So now you can see in our board. See the program as we wrote in the program has been displayed in the display board. So like this, you can do many things in this. I'll show you there are many features in this. So including text, you can also show the image. You can also show the time, date and time. You can show the text. You can also show the image. You can also show humidity and temperature. You can show the stopwatch and counter also. So there are these there are six features in this. You can display in this board. So now I'll show you the there are many more features. As you can see here that there are three options: program, device and settings. So we'll go to the device. In device you can see all the details has been given here. So from the device mode you can control the board. This is a switch. In switch mode you can set the timing of the screen, that from what time the screen should be on and at what time it should be off. It will be automatically working. So you can also set the timing of the screen. You can change the brightness from here. Now it's 51%. You can change the brightness from here, brightness of the screen. You can also change the date and time. This is the hardware section, means the hardware of the controller hardware. And you can see here there is a remote. So with a remote you can also manually control from your phone also. As you can see, when I'll click on power off button, you can see this is the red and you can see the display is off. When I'll click again, you can see the it is green and the display is on. So you can control it from your phone. You don't need to switch the main switching. You can off it from your mobile phone itself. This is the upgrade firmware to update the software every time. Here is the Wi-Fi. In Wi-Fi you can see the name of the Wi-Fi and the password. You can also change. You can keep the password as you want. And here are the rest of the settings. You can change the language. You can there is a selection tools, font management. You can download more many fonts as you want. So this is our project. Hope you like it. Thank you.